Hello friends, welcome in our YouTube channel. Today in this video we are going to talk about the first chapter of Ashtanga Hridaya, that is Ayush Kamya Adhyaya, or it means desire for long life. So let's start with the first shloka, that is purpose of Ayurveda. So purpose of Ayurveda is आयु कामाय मानेन धर्मार्थ सुख साधनम आयुर्वेदोपदेशेषु विदेयः परमादरः. द मीनिंग ऑफ फर्स्ट लाइन इज आयु, दैट मीन्स लाइफ. कामाय मानेन, दैट मीन्स पर्पस. धर्म, अर्थ, सुख, साधनम. सो दीज आर द फोर पर्पस ऑफ आयु. सो पर्पस ऑफ लाइफ इज धर्म, अर्थ, काम एंड मोक्ष. धर्म इट मीन्स डूइंग द थिंग्स इन अ राइट वे. इट मीन्स वॉट एवर यू आर डूइंग दैट शुड बी इन करेक्ट मैनर. सेकेंड अर्थ, इट मीन्स मनी. सो अर्निंग मनी इन अ लीगल वे इज अ अर्थ. एंड कर्म, इट मीन्स फुलफिलिंग द डिजायर्स और फुलफिलिंग अवर विशेस. Okay, and last is salvation. It means achieving the salvation or moksha prapti. So these are the four purpose of life are explained in this first line. Now second line. Second line is ayurvedopadeshesu videya paramadara. It means to achieve this four purpose of life, one should follow the principles of Ayurveda. It means Updesh which is given in the Ayurveda. It means one should have long life to achieve this four purpose. And to achieve the long life, person should follow the Ayurveda. So overall meaning is this, that purpose of life is Dharma, Artha, Kama and Moksha. And to achieve this purpose, one should have long life. And to achieve the long life, person should follow Ayurveda. So, this is the overall meaning of this shloka. Now, we will see the second shloka, that is Tridosha. This is Vayu Pittam Kafascheti Trayodosha Samasatah Vikrata Avikrata Deham Nanti Te Vartayanti Cha. It means there are three types of dosha or three doshas is present in our body, right? So three doshas are present in our body, that is vayu, it means vata, pittam, it means pitta, kafascheti, it means kapha. These are the three dosha, trayo dosha, samasatah. It means in body all these three doshas should be in the normal state or in the equilibrium state. Vikrata avikrata deham nanti te vartayanti cha. It means vikrata means imbalance, avikrata it means balance. So balance, imbalance of these three dosha leads to formation of disease in our body. And if these three doshas are in balance condition, it leads to good health. So overall meaning of this shloka is all the three doshas present in our body should be in the normal state. If this is in imbalance state, then it will cause disease in the human body. Now we will see the site of tridosha. In earlier shloka we have seen that the three doshas are present in our body and that should be in normal state. Now we will see their sites or locations where these three doshas are located in our body. So the shloka is te vyapino api hanya bhyo radho madhyo urdhva samshraya. Here samshraya means location or located. Hanya bhyo अधो मध्यो ऊर्ध्यो. यहाँ हियर अधो मीन्स below the body, below the umbilicus, in the lower region of the body. Madhyo, it means in the middle region of the body. And urdhva, it means the upper region of the body. Right? Now, te vyapino api, it means normally three doshas are present in all over the body. But especially specific dosha have some particular location in their body. Now, what is that location? So, pitta. Pitta is present between the heart and umbilicus. It means in the middle region of the body. And vata. Vata is located in the lower region of the body or below the umbilicus. And kapha. Kapha is located in the upper region of the body or above the chest. So, these are the specific location of all the three doshas. Now, we will see the relation between dosha, age, day, night and diet or circadian rhythm. So, the shloka is Vayo aho ratri bhuktanam te antyam madhya digaha kramat. Here, Vayo means age, aho means day, ratri means night and bhuktanam it means diet or food. Te antyam madhya digaha. Ant. Ant means last. Madhya. It indicates middle. Adi. It means start or commencement. Kramat. Kramat means in given order. Like last, middle and start. Now, let's see the meaning of shloka. Now, as what is the relation of dosha in age? So, in child age, kapha dosha is dominant in the human body. In the middle age, pitta dosha is dominant in the body. And in old age, vata dosha is dominant in the body. So, what is the order of three doshas? That is vata, pitta and kapha. And here we are saying the order should be last, middle and start. It means in the last old age, vata should be predominant, right? In last old age, vata is predominant. In middle age, pitta is predominant. And in child age, kapha is predominant, right? You have often seen that the children are more prone to kapha disorders like common cold, sneezing and other sort of kapha disorder in which kapha dosha is aggravated in our body. So, this is the example that in child age, kapha is dominant in our body, right? And in middle age, you have often seen that the adult person have high digestive power or he is more angry in nature. So that is because of pitta, right? And he often has more gastric problem, acidity like. So like this is just an example for understanding, right? And in old age, you have often seen that the older people are always suffering from arthritis type problem. They always have pain in their knee and other joints. So that is because of vata. Increase in vata cause such kind of disorder in human body. So this was the relation between age and doshas. Now we see the relation between doshas and day. So day, in morning time, kapha is predominant in our body. In afternoon, pitta is dominant in our body. And in evening, vata is dominant in our body. So here, morning, we can consider the time from 6 am to 10 am. That is period of kapha. In afternoon, we can consider the time from 10 am to 2 pm. That is period of pitta. When pitta is dominant in our body And in evening time, we can consider the time from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. in the evening. So, and in that time, Vata is dominant in our body, right? So, here also sequence is Vata, Pitta and Kapha. Last, middle and start, right? Now, similarly in the night, in early night, Kapha is dominant. In middle of the night, Pitta will be dominant. In late night, Vata will be dominant, right? And this is the same. Last, middle and start. Vata, Pitta, Kapha is dominant accordingly, right? Now, let's see the diet. What is the relation between diet and dosha? So, when we have taken the food, then immediately after taking food, Kapha will be dominant in your body. In the middle of the digestion, when acid is secreting from in stomach and it is help in digesting your food, at that time Pitta will be dominant. It means in the middle of digestion, pitta will be dominant. At the end of digestion, Vata will be dominant, right? So Vata, Pitta, Kapha, right, in this order. You can also feel the dominancy of these three doshas after taking food. As you have taken a food, immediately after taking food, you will feel laziness in your body. So that laziness is caused by the aggravation of Kapha. And in between the digestion, it means in the middle of digestion, you will feel heating in your body. So that heating is caused by Pitta aggravation. And at the end of digestion, it means when you have taken a food and after interval of around 1 and 2 hours, you will again get activated. So that activation in your body is because of Vayu or Vata dosha. Now we will see the relation between fire and doshas. Fire means digestive fire, right, which helps in the digestion process or breakdown of food. Or types of digestive fires, right? How many types of digestive fires? So the shloka is Terb Ved Vishamah Tikshno Mandas Chagni Samay Samaha. It means there are four types of digestive fire, right? First is Vishama Agni. It means unsteady digestive fire. Here, in digestive fire, there will be fluctuation. Sometime it gets aggravated and sometimes it becomes low. So, there will be fluctuation in digestive fire. That is called unstable or unsteady state of digestive fire or Vishama Agni. So this kind of digestive fire is due to aggravation of Vata dosha in our body, right? Aggravation of Vata dosha cause unsteady digestive fire. Now let's see the second Agni, that is a Tikshna Agni or high digestive power. This is because of increase in Pitta dosha. When Pitta dosha will aggravate in the body, it will cause the high digestive power, right? So that is a Tikshna Agni. Now we will see the Manda Agni. It means the low digestive power. Increase Kapha dosha leads to low digestive power. So increment of Kapha dosha causing the lowering the digestive power. Now we will see the Samagni, that is normal digestion. So if all the three doshas are in normal state, then your digestion power or digestive fire will be in normal state or in equilibrium state. That is a good state, right? So This was the relation between doshas and digestive fire.